tell them I just wanna shine and I gotta let it show. Show up on the scene, walk right through the door. Got a nigga on repeat, it's my double up flow. Vibrate the whole building, name ringing through your phone. Wait until the smoke clear, can you see me through the fog? Fall back, it could go all bad. We be going hard with your exotic.
So I woke up at 7 a.m. tired as heck. So I was like, I'll go to bed for 2 hours. I'll wake up at 9 and, you know, record my daily MLB recap. I wake up, it's 12. So I'm sorry if this MLB recap is going to be a little later than usual, but still going to get it out. We had some games yesterday. My Cubs got killed. But you know what? It's okay. It's not even the worst loss that happened to me today. I swear to God, if the Leafs lose that series, I'm going to make such a big rage video. Anyway, let's get into it. The first game was the Pirates snapping a 6-game losing streak with a win against the Minnesota Twins. This was an exciting game. It was 5-3 Twins after an Eddie Rosario homer in the fifth. Phillip Evans cut it to a 1-run lead. And then Kevin Newman in the bottom of the ninth, down by 2 runs, smacks this ball up the middle. 2 runs come around to score, and the Pirates walk off on the Twins 6-5. Exciting game in that one. Good job by Kevin Newman coming in clutch. He did that against the Cubs, too. Kevin Newman definitely shows up when it matters the most. The Rockies defeated the Giants 6-4. It was 3-1 Giants after a Marciano Dubon 3-run shot. But they rallied back, and this Daniel Murphy home run gave them the lead 4-3. And then Charlie Blackmon followed it with a homer of his own. And that's all that the Rockies needed to win. This is a crazy game. At the start of the seventh inning, it was 1-0 Rockies. 76% win probability for the Rockies. By the end of the top half of the inning, it was 78% in the Giants' favor. And then at the end of the seventh altogether, it was 82% in the Rockies' favor. You just see the win probability just goes like that. It's really cool. I'm a nerd, and I like that stuff. So Rockies get a win in that one. The A's, I think, have now won 6 in a row as they defeat the Texas Rangers 6-4. They got out of the gates early against starting pitcher who started Mike Minor, gave up 5 runs in 5 innings. The Rangers would rally back, but it wasn't quite enough. Matt Olson homered again. I think that's 3 homers in the last 2 games for him. He kind of had a slow start to the season, but he's turning it around nicely. So the A's win there, I think, 6 straight. The Angels completely dismantled the Mariners 6-1. Taijuan Walker did not pitch very well in this one. Shohei Ohtani homered. Max Stassi had a sack fly and a homer. And the Mariners couldn't really get anything against Dylan Bundy, who pitched 9 innings, gave up 1 run, 10 strikeouts. Gotta love it when a pitcher goes 9 innings. They don't do that anymore. So shout out to Mr. Bundy there. The Phillies defeat the Yankees 5-4. And JT Realmuto hit this 3-run home run in the first inning to sort of give them a nice little footing to start the game. Phil Gosselin tacked on some insurance runs. They jumped out to a big lead. The Yankees did make it interesting, but the Phillies hold on to win that one 5-4. The Indians completely just burned the Indians at the state. I mean, they 13-0 your final score. Jose Ramirez homered, Jose Ramirez tripled, and Jose Ramirez homered again. So that's 11 total bases from him right there. I don't know if he had any other hits, but hold on. Did he have any other hits? How many total bases did Jose Ramirez have? He went 3-for-5. Okay, so he had 11 total bases in that game. Fantastic stuff from Jose Ramirez. The Indians had 20 total bases as a team compared to the Indians' 4. Luis Castillo gave up 3 earned runs in 5 innings, and then the bullpen completely collapsed. Carlos Carrasco pitched 6 shutout innings, and the Indians win that one. I think Jose Ramirez is going to be our player of the day, but we'll have to see. Braves win a good one against the Jays, 4-3. This one ended in dramatic fashion. Freddie Freeman homered in the first. Bo Bichette cut the lead in half in the fourth. Adam Duvall had a sac fly to make it 3-1. Vlad Guerrero had an RBI single. And then Teoscar Hernandez with an RBI single. But in the bottom of the ninth, nobody on. Nick Markakis calls game 392 feet. It's out of here. And the Braves win that one by a score of 4-3. Nick Markakis walks it off. Fantastic stuff there at SunTrust Park. Braves looking like a really solid team. Diamondbacks win their second game in a row as they defeat the Astros 5-4. Another walk-off in this one. Arizona held the lead 3-2, but then Alex Bregman with this two-run homer gave them the lead in the top of the eighth inning. But have no fear, Cole Calhoun is here. This double into the gap, Tim LaCastro and Nick Ahmed both come around to score. And the Diamondbacks walk off on the Astros 5-4. The Diamondbacks had a terrible start to the season, but with two wins in a row, they might be getting back on track. So Cole Calhoun. Do we have to talk about the Cubs game? I don't want to talk about the Cubs game. Cubs lose to the Royals 13-2. Remember how I said Tyler Chatwood was like one of the best pitchers in the rotation and he was like performing really well and I really liked how he was doing. How about 8 earned runs in 2 1/3? Ryan O'Hearn, I think, Soler homered, former Cub. Salvador Perez helped out too, just a complete dismantling. Absolutely pitiful. Terrible performance. And can't play the Cardinals today because we're too casino. Marlins win a fun one against the Orioles 8-7. And this one was interesting. I think this one was held in Baltimore again. I don't know. Back and forth game. Bryant Anderson continues his reign of terror. He had a triple. Just a complete back and forth game all around. Really not much else to say. Terrific hitting performance. And the Marlins are 6-1. Don't look now, but they're like the number one seed in the NFC, not the NFC, the National League. And lastly, we have the Brewers winning 8-3 over the White Sox. My friend said Christian Yelich went yard because he hit a 319-foot home run. How's that possible? He hit an inside the park home run from Christian Yelich. That's only his second home run on the year, but hey, they all count the same. Obviously, El Garcia and Jed Jerko both went deep, and the Brewers have an offensive explosion. They beat the White Sox 8-3. Your play of the day is that Christian Yelich inside the park home run. Those are always exciting. Your player of the day is Jose Ramirez. 2 home runs and a triple? Good on you, Jose. That will end this episode of Daily MLB Recaps. Hope you guys enjoyed all the highlights. I tried to add more in these videos. But yeah, see you guys next time. Peace out.